everyone. When customers are exposed to great experiences every day of their life, they get used to it, and that becomes the de facto standard. Restaurants can be reserved with a click of a button. Food gets delivered with a few clicks and shows up in 30 minutes or less. Products can be bought with one click and delivered within hours or days. And ride shares show up in a few minutes with upfront prediction on costs and time to destination, and no payments are required at the end of the ride. When that happens several times a day to all of us, then that becomes the de facto standard that we expect as customers, and that includes customers of B2B companies. The million-pound question is, how is all of this possible? How do companies deliver top-notch experiences like this? And the answer is simple. They know a lot about their customers. They know a lot about the market, the conditions, the competition. This game is all about data and the intelligence built on top of it. This is the experience economy, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing less will do. Every interaction with your customers, both digital and physical, is an opportunity to learn more. Each one of these touch points generates customer data unique to that interaction. An order number, a cookie, an email, a billing address, what products are they interested in, what products did they buy, did they leave a review, was it a good one or a bad one, did they open the last email that you sent them about the new product launch, and did they take any action on it, where do they live, what do they prefer, all kinds of interesting data. But what companies struggle with is how to capture and bring this data together. Often they do not have the right resources to do this. It is a daunting task. But often these companies do not realize how valuable this data is and what an amazing ROI they can get with this effort. In a study conducted by consulting firm McKinsey, they found that the more a company knew about their customers, the more successful they were likely to be as a business. Just knowing name, phone number, address, and email address is not enough anymore. Of course, it is way better than not knowing anything about your customers, but really, knowing more gives you significantly better chance of being successful. Knowing what products did your customers buy? When did they buy it? Did they get a discount? Did they buy insurance to go with it? When does the warranty run out? And what are they interested in today? Are they in the market? Are they brand conscious? Are they value shoppers? How many people are in their household? Who is the primary shopper? What is the household income? And lots of information like that. This data is worth its weight in gold, and all this data allows companies to build sophisticated predictors and models that can help identify who are the most loyal customers, what their yearly spend is going to be, or the lifetime value of that customer. It can help identify what products are selling and which ones are not. Who is the ideal buyer of these products? It makes your revenue projections and your supply chain planning significantly better. And it allows you to create the right pricing and discounting strategies for your products. You all just heard about this company planning its expansion in the high-end washer and dryer business. They built that plan on GfK's amazing data set on markets, competition, and consumer sentiment data. After all, introducing washer and dryers in a crowded field may not be the best strategy. Now imagine that they can do a little more with that data, because now they have some amazing data about their customers to build upon. Based on insights about their loyal customers in the United Kingdom, this company might have found that there is a strong correlation between refrigerators and washer dryers, meaning people who buy refrigerators also tend to buy washer dryers. This insight can truly help curate a list of these customers that are likely to be the right customers who might want to buy these high-end washers and dryers. And maybe this list isn't very large to create an effective marketing campaign to launch this product in the market. But with the right data and the right partnerships, you could do what is called in the industry lookalike modeling for digital advertising, where this company is now capable of creating a cohort of potential customers to address that group of people with the right campaign in front of them at the right time and convert them. So, how do you get started on this journey? Well, there are five simple steps. Number one, you start by identifying all the data you need for a complete understanding of your customer. Remember what I said, the more you know, the better. Find ways to gather this information. Number two, pick a platform and vendor that can help you connect the dots and start consolidating this data in one place. You might need a data lake, a consumer data platform, or something similar. Anything that is both performant and one that can scale. Research what capabilities these platforms and vendors can offer that allow you to do this without needing an army of data engineers and data scientists. Let's face it, these data scientists are really hard to find. Number three, leverage and enrich the data with second and third-party data sources. GfK just showed you what you can do to leverage their data. That's fantastic data. You might find other kinds of data enrichment capabilities from other vendors in the market that provide things like household income for each one of your existing loyal customers. Number four, make sure that your front office applications in marketing, service, sales, etc., can leverage this data and contribute back to it. Service and support calls are often great opportunities to learn more and build a better customer happiness and loyalty score. These days, customers are very happy to give phone numbers for getting notifications on delivery and service calls. Number five, last but not the least, glean information and insights through the data to deliver better results. Your customers are leaving lots of breadcrumbs with every touch point they have with you. People often ask me, how is it even possible to have 300 attributes for a customer? And my answer to them is that they are being myopic with their view of customer data. Take a look at the questions I have posed on this slide. I guarantee you that I could come up with 10 slides with questions just like this in a little over an hour. Oracle's customer data platform, Unity, comes with 300 attributes out of the box. This is the starting point. You can add as many more as you want. Bottom line is that any company can and should find lots of data about their customers. Now, once you have the data, where do you store it? And believe me when I say this, it is not just about storing the data. It is how you access the data, how you put it to work, how you build intelligence on top of it. You need a platform that can do many of the following things. It can bring in data continuously from multiple sources. I have customers with as many as 35 or more sources that they're pulling this data constantly. Align that data to fit the schema that you decide works best for your business. And then being able to clean and validate the data, being able to do identity matching and resolution so that you can remove duplicates. You want to enrich this data. You want to make the data accessible to applications and humans alike. And do all of this without writing code. Be able to do segmentation for targeting. Be able to derive intelligent attributes, things like churn propensity score, lifetime value, next best action or offer. Be able to derive brand loyalty. Be able to communicate and find out if your customers are fatigued because you are over-communicating, and hundreds of other capabilities. You need a vendor that can work with you to not only bring a platform like this to life, but can also help you get it up and running in short order. There are lots of amazing ways to leverage the data. For example, property insurers can really subscribe to data sources to analyze weather patterns, be able to understand historical weather patterns to calibrate insurance coverage requirements by geographies. Restaurants might subscribe to population and location data to identify optimal regions for expansion. Where should they place their next restaurants? This would allow our example company to grow the size of their targeted audience in France, for example, in the high-end washer and dryer business, to include lots of new prospects who purchase similar or complementary products or services from a direct competitor. Imagine if you could find a correlation between people who buy particular brands of high-end washing detergents and people who own high-end washer dryers. Wouldn't we want to target those customers? It might help them decide what is the most optimal time to launch their products in the market based on buying patterns. It might also help them with pricing and discounting strategies. And when you start connecting all your front office applications, you now have the power to provide the best experiences to your customers at every touch point. Every one of these touch points will build loyalty, improve retention rates, increase revenue for the company, decrease costs, all kinds of stuff. This is how you grow your business. Imagine that your customer support recognizes the customers based on where the call comes in from. They can address the customers by their first name and know what products or services they might be calling about. And maybe you have been monitoring your customers' activity on your website, which suggests they might have a problem with their dryer, that you already have a ready answer for them. And when you are really good at this, you did not even wait for that call to happen because you already addressed their issue via chat on the website. Imagine that. And that data is now captured in your customer data platform, and based on that interaction, classifies them as a happy and referenceable customer. That could trigger an email to ask them to give a review and get a 15% discount on the next purchase. When your data is connected, and it is clean and current, now your entire business has the chance to be truly connected and working as one. An airline once asked me if a strategy like this could help them stop sending a customer promotional messages when that customer is sitting at an airport because their flight was delayed or canceled. A large e-commerce company asked me if he can identify when a customer has already purchased a product so that they can stop advertising to them and save advertising costs. And a supercar company asked if he could help the dealers identify what additional products and services they can sell and when to their customer base. The good news is all of this is possible if you put in the effort into it. Collecting all the appropriate data about your customers is the foundation, but real value can be derived when you start applying AI and machine learning to this data. Here are some examples of what we do with this data today. When to send an email? Should it be at 7 a.m. in the morning or 7 p.m. in the evening? And we can do that for each customer. Slight improvements in open rates can make big differences in ROI. What should the subject line be? Is it better to use words like luxury or innovation or environmentally conscious in the subject line? Is it better to send email or SMS to this customer? What does the customer prefer? What should the content look like? Should the price be crossed out and show discounts because maybe that's get people excited? And when to stop communicating? Have you over-communicated with your customers? Are some of them fatigued? Should you stop for a while? This kind of intelligence will drive significantly better results for your customers and for your business. And when you have done all of this, really, when you have put in the effort and you put your mind and your resources to work, you will have taken your business to the next level. Ladies and gentlemen, it was great to be here. Thank you for having me here today.